Welcome, Rami. If you don't mind, could you please just introduce yourself?
Hi, I'm Rami Hourani. I am a McGill alumnus. I did my PhD and I graduated in 2009. I worked in Dr. Ashok Kakkar's lab and worked closely also in the beginning of my PhD with Professor Whitehead on modeling. Then in 2010, I moved to Berkeley and I did my postdoc in UC Berkeley in material science and engineering. In 2011, I networked with people from Intel Corporation that were doing work at UC Berkeley, and they asked me to apply for a position at Intel. Then I interviewed and I started a career at Intel. I worked there for 8 years in components research. Then from there, I decided to make a career change and I joined Applied Materials and the CTO office, where we work on an area which is engineered optics for AR and VR applications.
How did the skills you developed in grad school contribute to a job that's so diverse at Intel?
That's a very good question. The skills you gain in your PhD is all about determination, and it's about finding solutions with whatever resources you have. So the ability to multitask and work under stress and focus on solving problems is what you get from your PhD. That's why companies like Intel hires people from various backgrounds and train you on the spot to handle different types of problems. But they rely on the fact that your graduate program develop those skills in you to be able to handle and keep their production or research or development going. When I was offered the position, it was, I think, called dielectric engineer position, which I had no idea what that means. And when I read the job description, I said, I'm a synthetic chemist. How the heck does that apply to what I'm doing or what you saw me doing at Berkeley, right? And they said, oh, don't worry, just go ahead and interview and then we'll tell you details later. And then once I was in there, I discovered there's tons of chemistry to do. If you think about all components of a microprocessor, it's all chemicals, right? It's all compounds and materials that you manipulate and change the properties of it. So what's the source of it is you need chemists to play and manipulate the materials in order to fit the application that the industry is asking for. Some parts of the industry or jobs don't give you that full exposure, of course, to use your chemistry skills directly. But no matter what, your PhD has taught you more than the subject matter that you're studying. The key thing for graduate students is don't be intimidated by job descriptions. Don't limit yourself to specific job titles that relate exactly to your PhD title, right? You have to expand and explore, and you'll be surprised what's out there that can actually benefit from your skills.
What's one thing you wish you learned as a graduate student?
I would say, and this might be in general, a lot of graduate students go through this. You, especially towards the end, you end up becoming in a bubble almost because you have a thesis. You want to finish your thesis. You want to graduate, right? You don't want to spend too many years in your graduate program. So you just focus on your topic, right, of your PhD thesis. And you end up losing a lot of that vital time where you can explore and bridge into other things. So for example, I'm basically focused on synthesis, right? So I'm a synthetic chemist and my goal was to build those macromolecules for drug delivery system towards the end of my PhD. But what I noticed is I did not pay enough attention or concentrated on the material side of what I'm doing, right? Where is it gonna go next? Can I broaden my knowledge about the next things? Where can I take these things beyond just the focus of my thesis, right? What I would have done differently is I would have expanded my knowledge and actually had more hands-on on applying what I was making and seeing it actually as a product or material in action. So we did collaborate with people in the Faculty of Medicine, but basically I felt like my job is I'm just going to make a compound and hand it to you, right? And you tell me if it works or not, right? Yeah, sure. I did read superficially to some extent on what is the main concept. But I think if I invested in that years before, understanding how my materials could work in the system, I would have taken more of a lead role and it broadened my own knowledge and see how my what I make go further in the world, basically. Yeah. So yeah. Expand your knowledge.
That's it for the questions. So
yeah. All the best and merci beaucoup.